You know, I'm often asked, Steve, are you ever going to retire? Well, the answer is no, because I have a little one to take care of. And here he is, Martin Short.
Can I go to stand-up comedy? Is that not the toughest form of humour going? I mean, that requires confidence.
Well, it's certainly, there's no, when you're doing a stand-up, like we do it, we have each other. But when you're doing stand-up, you have no one. So you have to bounce off yourself. And if you have a lull in a stand-up, it's a nightmare. Whereas, you know, Marty comes out and we got this incredible lull and the audience doesn't seem to mind.
Oh, I love this and the best! Thank you, ladies and gentlemen!
No, it is amazing though that you, if you do a joke that doesn't work, it does affect the next two or three jokes. The audience is still saying, oh, he's not any good. And they're not, and if you have a joke that kills, so if you're the person doing those jokes and they're not working, you're very aware of the lull.
I've written about it in my book. I called stand-up comedy the ego's last stand.
It is the ego's last stand.
That's good.
You should read my book.
I know. Yeah. Well, at first I thought it was pop-up, and then I was intrigued, but when I found out, no.
Had words.
May I say, you look fantastic. And I guess that's the benefit of looking 70 since you were 30.
With comedy, do you have to have a nub of truth, a kernel of truth in all jokes? Is that really for a good joke? It has to have some truth.
You have to be able to get it. It can't be so obscure that you go. I mean, often we'll look at jokes and say, we'll both say to each other, I don't get it. I don't, what?
Is there anything off limits when it comes to
comedy? I think
comedy?
There's plenty off limits for us, not for other people. But for us, there's certain things we just don't talk about, A, because it's too cruel. It might get us in trouble, you know, or what else? I don't know. It might hurt somebody in a you know.
Well, you don't want to hurt people.
No, you don't want to hurt people.
You want to hurt them a little bit.
Yeah.
No, we don't. We don't really. And a lot of jokes, we would not show to their targets. Would you say?
Correct.
Yeah. But they might get wind of it.
Yeah. So what's off limits?
I once was doing this show on Broadway, and I had this joke. I was playing an old songwriter, Irving Cohen, and the joke was, Paris Hilton, she might be a Hilton, but she stoops like a Motel 6, which is a low-rent motel. And then I realized her mother was in the audience.
So what is off limits for you guys then?
Cruelty or
illness.
You know, illness is certainly off limits because, you know, when you're younger, you just don't care. As you're older, you have empathy, you know, and there might be somebody, I worry about somebody in the audience who might be suffering from something or a loss or something like that. And I don't want to make them feel bad, I guess. But
But also, I don't know how you. No, but I don't know if you're talking about a loss or illness. What joke would be funny about that?
I've heard a million jokes about
it.
Yeah, I do a joke about my mother's dementia.
Well, that's a little different because you set it up.
Yeah, right. That is.
Honestly,
yeah.
You said it's tragic and sad and at times hysterical, and I'll explain.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess that's my point. A lot of comedians would argue you can laugh at most things if you set it up.
Yes, I think that's true for the personality.
Okay.
And when I was younger, I did a lot of like rude things, and Richard Pryor could say and do anything. So it's up to your personality at the time and the moment.
But Richard Pryor would say anything, but it was always there was always truth in what he was saying on some level.
That's what she was saying.
Mm. Who's she?
Liz.
Oh, yeah. When did you get here?
Yeah. A little while ago.
Oh, for God's sake.
Did you realize she's been asking you questions?
Nope.
You just talking.
I thought it was just that voice in my head talking to me again.
Okay, go ahead.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9 Now app for full episodes, another exclusive 60 Minutes content.